Good afternoon. Bert Newton entertained Australians. He made us laugh sometimes until we cried for decades. And today the TV legend has received a special farewell from friends, family and the industry he loved. Reid Butler is at St Patrick's Cathedral in Melbourne for us. Reid, good afternoon to you. It was clear how much everyone loved him and there were so many big names there.
Yeah, stars of the stage and screen, Davina, people who've known and loved Bert for decades, they all came out on this drizzly Melbourne morning to pay their respects. The weather matching the mood, I've got to say, a solemn event, but still a healthy dose of showbiz scattered throughout. After all, we are talking about Bert Newton here. His widow Patty and their daughter Lauren and the grandkids arrived in style in a stretch white limousine. Patty got out of the car and blew kisses at the fans that had gathered here to share their memories and pay their respects. 500 guests were in attendance at the service. That number capped at 500 for COVID-safe reasons. Many celebrities, as we mentioned, but also politicians too, from the Prime Minister down. Everyone more than willing to share their memories of Bert on the way into the cathedral.
Love you, Patty! I love it!
I love you too!
We just adored him. Everybody adores him.
And how are you feeling ahead of today, the service?
I'm incredibly honoured to be able to celebrate a marvellous man. Yeah, and my heart goes out to his family. Yeah, and all his showbiz family.
We learned a lot from Bert. His legacy was making people laugh, and you couldn't want for a better legacy.
And how are you feeling ahead of today?
Oh, I'm okay. I realised that he'd been ill for a while, and I think one of the greatest things to say is that for Patty, Patty's been amazing. She's kept herself busy. She is heartbroken, of course, but she's an amazing woman and was always great support for Bert.
I have known and loved Bert Newton my entire life. We're talking 40 years, so many memories. My first appearance on live television was the Don Lane Show, 1981, so there's a lot of history, and I guess the proudest thing is that not only was Bert my hero and mentor, a very close family friend.
Bert spent an entire lifetime dedicated to making other people smile. Came into our living rooms and right across the country every week, almost every day. And what a wonderful way to spend your life, just making people feel better about themselves, giving them a smile.
Yes, so much emotion, Reid, and that was before the service even started. Talk us through the funeral itself.
Well, Bert was a devout Catholic, Davina, so the service was a traditional Catholic requiem mass. There were touching tributes from the Premier Daniel Andrews and Eddie Maguire as well. At one point, a highlights reel was played of Bert's career, and that got some laughs and helped lighten the mood a little bit. Some beautiful performances too by Sylvie Palladino. She sang the national anthem and Anthony Kalia sang the prayer, which was a really special thing to see. COVID-safe measures were in place throughout the service. Of course, guests needed to sit 1.5 metres apart unless they were in a couple. Everyone needed to wear a mask, be double vaccinated. There were limits as to how many people could sit on each pew. But that didn't take away from the service at all. It was incredibly special. Here are some of the highlights from the speeches.
He had a supreme talent, a gift indeed. And when things went off script, when a show went off the rails, Bert thrived. He was in his element, witty, clever, cheeky.
The young boy from Fitzroy who became a star, then a legend, then an institution, and now our greatest memory of the golden years of television. Forever, our Bert.
Yeah, he was our Bert, a showman, a very public figure, but more than anyone else, he was his family's person. He'd a father and a husband, and we heard from the family today.
Yeah, Davina, I mentioned that Patty was here with their daughter Lauren and the six grandkids, but there was one family member who wasn't able to attend, Matthew Newton, Bert's son. He lives and works in New York City as a writer and director, so he wasn't able to be here today, but both he and Lauren wrote a letter to Bert to be read out during the service, and that honour was delivered by Pete Smith. He read that letter. Here's a bit of it now.
Over the last 10 years, while I've lived abroad,
Dad and I would play our conversational songs over Zoom and FaceTime. Tools that allowed me to connect. Family always came first for Dad, and he included us in everything he did. He and Mum were a team, and he wanted all of us around and to be part of everything he did. He always made me feel very special, and I knew I could always count on him.
Davina, the hearse is about to leave St Patrick's Cathedral here in East Melbourne now. The guests are starting to leave as well. The hearse will leave under a police escort. Paddy has said that Bert would have been overwhelmed and overjoyed at the honour of being honoured like this at a state funeral. And it really was a special service, one that does the Australian television icon justice.
Such a fitting farewell. Reid, thank you.